Happy Christmas, you lazy sod.
Can't believe you slept in on Christmas Day.
Happy Christmas, boy.
Thanks, sir. And yous too.
Hey, Luke. Santa's been.
Great.
All these for me?
Yeah. I put some thought into your prezi this year. Didn't I, sir? Hey? Instead of just getting the usual pair of Al's slippers, you know.
Oh, gloves. Oh, Dad.
Wait till you see the others.
Oh, and a scarf.
A matching scarf? You're always complaining the other one's ready for the bin, aren't you?
Yeah. You really know to spoil a girl, don't you?
Just keep your nose out of it, please. Go on, open your last one.
Oh, the earmuffs. Oh, thanks, love.
Yeah? I thought you'd enjoy doing a bit of painting. You know, like you did on your holiday.
What is it? Paint by numbers.
Well, they are. Paint away to your heart's content now, can't you? With a little bit of help.
Yeah. Right, I'll just start peeling this fudge, shall I? You haven't opened your present off our Lindsay yet?
Yeah. I will in a minute.
Why can't Matt peel these?
Because I asked you to. Yeah, don't worry, he'll be doing the dishes.
Anything I can do?
No, love, I think we're quite ready. I'll be putting the veg on now, so you'll have plenty of time for your dinner before you go to the garage.
Oh, I can't believe I've got to go to work. I mean, who needs petrol on a Christmas day?
Well, at least it's only for a couple of hours.
Why are you walking around with a gob on you? It's supposed to be Christmas.
Yeah.
What time's Katie coming, love?
She isn't.
She's not coming for a dinner with us.
Has she changed her mind?
Looks like it could be my turn soon, then.
Matt.
She's dumped him, then.
Oh, but they were getting on so well. No wonder he's been so quiet. What's gone on there, then?
Well, Katie obviously got bored of him and moved on to the next poor sucker.
Yeah, okay, Ryan.
Well, I bet she's getting a real kick out of ruining our Luke's Christmas.
Come on, you don't know that's what's happened.
No. But I can guess.
Where are you going?
Out.
Where to?
Just out.
You're not going to Kitty's, are you?
No.
Ryan, I don't want you causing trouble, and Luke wouldn't be happy with you getting involved.
Look, I'm just going for a drink before me dinner, that's all.
All right.
Oh, Christmas.
Thanks.
Oh, hi. Merry Christmas.
Shelley?
Hi, princess. Look what I've got for you.
What'd you say?
Thank you.
Good girl.
And as if I'd forget you.
Wow, hey, look at this, son. Another prezi. Look at that wall. It's a big one, isn't it?
I've got a little something for you two for inviting me over as well.
Shut me up, love.
Happy Christmas. It's not very much, though.
No. Oh. Hey, they're gorgeous, thanks.
There you go.
Oh, thanks. Oh, wait, look at that. Yeah, that'd be dead interesting in there. Thanks, Shell.
Yeah, and this. Well, Lindsay said you're interested in art, so I thought you might like that.
I just feel terrible, love. I didn't get you anything.
Oh, don't be. It's just a thank you for having me over, really.
Yeah. Right, come on. It's your turn.
Right, I'm going to grab a breath of fresh air before we have our dinner.
Oh, no, you don't. You are not messing about in that shed again today.
No way.
No, Jimmy, you can come and help me with the sprouts. Come on.
Right.
Hi, go on. Open up.
Oh, it is gorgeous.
It's the one you said you really liked. Mm.
Very thoughtful.
Our Luke's dead miserable, and I reckon it's down to you.
Leave me alone.
Why, have you finished with him? Found someone else, have you, already, you slag? Well, come on! I want to know why my brother's hanging around the house looking totally miserable.
Just go away.
No. Not till you tell me what's going on. Why have you finished with him?
Because he's a rapist, that's why. Confessed everything to me.
Right, this only needs dishing out. You may as well get them all sat down.
Hey, look at her.
She's made up with that pretty Shelley gave her.
Carly's very fond of her, isn't she?
Yeah.
Right, come on. Dinner's ready.
Mum, can I sit by Shelley?
Of course you can.
Come on, mister. It's ready for your Christmas dinner.
Your love, I'll put you around there if that's all right.
Okay.
Kylie, you good day?
Yeah, it's coming now.
What are you thinking about?
Listen, Nan. Project.
This time last year, you were studying thinking about that girl at school.
Oh. Susan Clark. No presents for her this year. Or ever. But her poor dad's having a lousy Christmas.
Bet lots of people are missing their loved ones. Wishing they were together. Dad. Since it's Christmas, can't we just make up? Forget all about this club business.
You know how I feel.
Where has he got to?
He said he was just popping out for a pint.
With who?
I don't know, love. Maybe one of his mates.
A mate? With our Ryan? No way.
Will you stop eating that turkey?
No, I'm starving.
So am I. Yeah, well, you won't be hungry if you keep eating those crisps.
Doesn't he know I've got to go to work? I mean, I won't have any time to eat. Look, you're just going to have to start dishing that stuff out. I'm going to have to go soon.
Didn't he say which mate he was going to see?
No. What time and all?
Great stuff, Dad. Can I have a leg, please?
Hurry up, love. Your dinner's ready. We thought we were going to have to start without you. Is everything okay?
Yeah. Fine.
I thought you two were getting on well.
Not that well, really.
Mike, will you do us a favour? I fancy some chocolate. Could you get some from the garage, please?
Yeah. No probs. Do you want anything, Katie?
No, thanks.
So, come on, are you going to tell me what's up?
Rach, I just can't believe it. I feel so stupid, so why was it? Luke said Mrs. you raped Nicky.
Oh, Kate.
This is delicious. I can't believe how much I've eaten. So it's like at least a week in the gym just to work this dinner off.
Oh, you don't need to lose weight.
You're right, Dom. Top scrounger.
Do you have to?
What?
Only you could polish off half a loaf with your Christmas dinner.
You know, the kids have got better table manners than you.
I always have bread and butter with me roast. You know that.
Yeah, but you have to do it today, though.
Oh, Shelley doesn't mind. Bet she has bread rolls with her dinner in their gaff. Hey, just like posh restaurants. Is that right, Shel?
My dad always used to mop his grave up with his bread. Drove my mum mad.
Ah, see?
Really?
Yeah.
Don't let the elocution lessons fool you. There was nothing posh about my upbringing. I lived in just a normal semi. And my mum did like to think she was better than most of the neighbours, but that was only because she did her step every other day rather than just once a week.
So what did your dad fella do, Sean?
He worked for the council, didn't he?
Yeah, in the rates department.
I always imagined your dad to be like a bank manager or a headmaster or something.
No, he was just a clerk. He really loved his job too. He died not long after he retired. I think he really missed going back to work. He used to just sit around the house, bored.
Well, it's hard for someone who's used to working to just stop one day and suddenly have nothing to do.
I was convinced it was him at first. But as things went on, I started to wonder whether, you know, Nicky had got it wrong.
I don't think anyone believed it in the end. It must have been terrible for her. No wonder she's been getting bladdered all the time.
Poor Nicky.
Why didn't I just believe her? She tried to warn me, but I wouldn't listen.
Stop blaming yourself. How were you to know he was guilty?
I got you a selection.
Look, you're going to have to go back to Anthea's without me.
Why?
You just will. I've got to stay here for a bit.
Well, what am I going to tell him?
Oh, just tell him something important's come up.
Right, OK.
I'm sorry, but I don't want to leave her.
Right. I'll see you later. Okay. See you later, Kate.
You don't have to stay. I'll be all right, honest.
I'd rather rather be here. Ron's millennium countdown is driving us all up the wall, especially Anthea.
But I'll be disappointed you're not there, and so will Mike.
I don't care. Ron's convinced I'm going to give birth today. Every time I move, he's ready to call an ambulance.
I wonder how Jackie's getting on at Nathan's. She'll love playing Lady of the Manor.
Lady Jacqueline of Coddington Hall.
At least one of us is having a good Christmas.
Just try and forget about him.
I can't believe how stupid I've been.
Don't be so hard on yourself. Luke lied to you like he lied to everyone else. You're not the only one who believed him.
Yeah, but not everyone else jumped into bed with him, Rach. I slept with him. I slept with a rapist.
That was great, Mum.
Oh, yeah, I'm stuffed. No, there's Christmas pudding, mince pies for afters.
Oh, God, I think I need to lie down.
You can forget the couch because I bagged you.
So soon?
You'll be sick.
Right, I better get going.
Are you sure you don't want to follow Santa Paul's, love? You know, they'd be really glad to see you.
No, thanks. I think I'll just come straight back here after I've finished in the garage.
Okay, we won't be late. You finished, love?
Yeah, thanks. It was lovely.
You've hardly eaten anything.
I think I had too much.
And you as well?
Sorry, I'm not that hungry.
Is it you and Katie, love?
No. I think I'll watch some telly.
What is going on? Where exactly did you get to before?
I told you, I just went for a pint.
Yeah, so what's with the atmosphere between you and Luke all of a sudden?
Oh, there is no atmosphere.
Oh, Ryan, I'm not stupid. What is going on? Is it something to do with Katie?
No.
Did you go and see her earlier?
Look, Mum, it's nothing. I've told you. Please, can we just drop it, eh?
The fast. Oh. I'll leave them to sleep for a couple of hours.
Oh. Under the spark, they've been up since half five.
I could just drop off myself.
So could I. I am bloated.
I'm not surprised. The dinner you put away, you finished off most of them sprouts on your own.
Yeah, well, no one else was bothering, were they?
They didn't get a chance.
Oh. I'll tell you something you better keep out of my way later on because sprouts make me fart like mad. Oh, Shelly doesn't mind, do you, Queen? Come on, top up. Don't be lagging behind.
Not for me. I'm driving later.
Oh, right, okay.
You're not staying?
Lins, but I'd rather get back. But I'm not going yet. Not until your dad's sprouts make a comeback, at least.
Hey, he'll be out in that garden at the first sign.
Well, actually, I was going to nip out for a breath of fresh air.
You just want to have a mess in that shed of yours, don't you?
No, just to let me dinner go down, that's all.
Go on, then. But don't be out there for hours, will you?
Of course not. Hey, listen, while the kids are out of the game, why don't you do some painting, knock out a bit of a landscape, you know, with your new paint set? It's a good idea, isn't it?
You want me to come down? The only landscape I'll be working on is that mountain of dirty dishes.
Lindsay and I will do the dishes. You relax. You've done enough today already.
Don't worry, love, I don't mind.
I don't believe it. What? Got to go and check the club out. The alarm's gone off.
Someone broken in?
No, the engineer just reckons it's a fault, but he wants me to meet him to make sure everything's okay.
Well, shall I come with you?
No, you stay here. I'll only be 10 minutes. Have a gab to my mum. Won't be long.
Okay, bye.
We're going soon, Kelly, love. Can you start getting ready?
Uncle Paul will be wondering where we are.
Now, why does Noel Matt have to go?
Because I'm going to Bosco's.
Don't you want to see your granddad?
Yeah, but it's not fair, is it? He gets a choice.
I'll be seeing you all later.
All right, bye, love. Come on, young lady. Ship yourself. Go on.
I wish you'd tell me what's up with you.
I told you, it's nothing.
I know you went to see Katie before. What did she say?
Okay. I did go over and see her. But she just told me that they split up over something.
Didn't she say what?
No, I don't want to know either. She just wound me up, that's all. So please, can we just drop it now?
Have you ever thought yourself, you know, about kids?
I think I'd like to be a mother one day, despite the obvious complications. But I'd have no qualms about raising a child without a man around.
Family is important, though, love.
As long as a child has a loving home, they have as much chance as anyone of growing up well-balanced. Lindsay's proved that with Kylie.
Yeah. And what about your family? I mean, how would they feel about you having kids?
Mum would love grandkids. And a son-in-law, probably, but I think she's resigned herself to the fact that she'll probably never have either.
Oh. And does she have a problem, like, with you?
Being gay? No, she's always been fine with it herself. It's what other people think that bothers her. She's spending Christmas with my aunt. I refuse to go because she just wouldn't let me tell the truth.
Yeah. I often wonder, you know, how I'd feel like if our Lindsay, you know,
came out.
Yeah.
Why do you think she will?
Well, I think you'd probably know more than me.
Are you asking me if Lindsay and I are having an affair?
It's none of my business.
Would it be a problem if we were?
She's my daughter. I'd support her whatever she wanted. It's her life. But I couldn't lie to you and say I'd be made up or anything.
Well, we're not. I think Lindsay's just confused at the moment. She's not sure what she wants. I think she's toyed with the idea, and I think she might even have a bit of a crush on me, but as far as I'm concerned, strictly friends. Anything else would just spoil our friendship.
I was just his next target, wasn't I? You can't think of it like that. You weren't raped.
But in a way, it feels like I was.
I'm sorry, Katie. You've got no idea what it feels like. Rach, I'm sorry I didn't mean to. It's okay. But just be grateful you don't know what it's like to be raped.
And then, when did you first realise that you were, like, you were gay?
Probably around the same age you first realised you were straight.
But it must have dawned on you that you were different from all the other girls at some point.
Not all the other girls. I think things were pretty much confirmed when I was on a school trip at about the age of 14. Julie Davis.
Do you know, I remember there was a girl in our school, we used to call it, well, a les, we used to say. Linda the Les, everyone used to call her. Wonder what happened to her.
Probably some housewife now, has nightmares about being persecuted in her youth.
Well, I never skittered her.
Oh, I bet you never got changed to swimming next door either.
Do you know, it's never even crossed my mind.
What?
Well, like, being with another woman.
Oh, I don't know what missing.
I just can't imagine it being like, you know.
What are you doing sitting in the dark?
We're just having a chat.
Where's Lindsay?
She's gone to the club.
I'd better make a move. I'm getting far too comfortable here.
Are you all right, love? More than welcome to stay, you know.
Yeah, Lindsay will be back any minute.
Oh, thanks, but I've got to go. I'm going to pop in to see Paula on the way back.
Huh. All right. Who's Paula?
My ex. We stayed friends. Look, thanks for everything.
Oh, no, listen, it was really nice talking to you.
Look, we'll enjoy your Christmas.
No.
And I'll see myself out.
Nice one, love. See you, ta-da.
Bye.
All the best, love.
Didn't you get your painting done, then?
No.
So what have you been doing?
Just sitting talking with Shelley.
Aye. It's a wonder she didn't throw the lips on you.
Jimmy!
Oh, I'm only joking.
Yeah, well, it's not funny. Or fair.
Ready?
Yep.
See you later.
Yeah, bye. Wish them all the best from me.
Okay. Bye.
So, where did you disappear to before dinner? What?
You did it, didn't you? You raped Nikki Chadwick.
What's that, Katie, isn't it? Just because I broke up with her. What's she been saying?
Stop it. She's telling the truth, isn't she? Isn't she?
I'm sorry.
Sorry? Sorry? How could you put Nikki through all that suffering? My mum through all that suffering because she thought you were in prison for something that you didn't do?
I am sorry, honestly.
We fought for you. We argued for you. All because you told us that you were innocent.
I didn't mean any of it. It all got out of hand and I couldn't stop it.
When she cried rape, I couldn't believe it. The pill was just supposed to relax her. I mean, she was all over me. You saw her. She was out cold. And you still did it to her. I was drunk. I thought she was. You're a liar. She was helpless. And you raped her. You raped her.
No.
Rapist.
No. No.
You brought us down to your level. All the things I did to Nikki, all the things I said. I'm almost as guilty as you.
Don't say that.
What's going on?
Well?
I raped her.
You what?
Nikki. It was me.
Wake the kids up when I finish this.
Hmm. Plenty of sliced turkey out there if they fancy a butty.
Hmm.
You've not long missed your mate.
Why didn't she wait for me to get back?
No, she had to go. She'd been here ages, love. But, you know, isn't she a lovely girl? We had a real good gap.
Well, you could have told her to have hung on for a few minutes more.
I never thought I could be ashamed of one of my own. But, Norman, you did. Just looking at you was turning my stomach. I'll never be able to forgive you for what you did to that girl. And this family. I never want to see you again.
Matt and Kelly, when are we going to see them?
You won't be seeing them. They're no longer part of this family.
Aren't you seeing Luke?
We finished.
I am sick of my son being slandered.
Niamh,
please. I hate seeing you like this. We haven't even wished each other Merry Christmas yet.
Just leave me alone, Joey, and don't you dare try and stop me!
And Brookside returns tomorrow night at 8:30.
The atmosphere in this house, but I know I've had enough of it.
Well, Luke and Ryan have obviously fallen out over something. Katie, probably. Can you just get yourself into town? Get your mind off it. Might even find a few bargains.
What's the big hurry to get me out of here?
What are you talking about?
You know more than you're letting on, don't you?
If I did, I'd tell you.
Right, love, I'm just going to go into town, try and get a few things for Leah and the sales. Do you think Abby will mind?
No, not at all.
Okay. See you later, Luke.
Bye, love.
Why don't you come with me?
I know, I'd rather stay in. There's a good film on, and I don't fancy all those crowds. Getting down here.
So did you all have a fantastic Christmas?
Certainly did. Jackie was the toast of Cuddington Hall. I'll let her tell you all about it when she gets in.
How was yours then?
It was quiet, but what we wanted, really.
Hey, Merry Christmas, everybody. I've got a couple of bottles of these. Thought we might as well open them today.
I was treated to a champagne breakfast Christmas morning. Brought to me in bed on a tray.
Sounds good.
Oh, it was. Best Christmas morning I ever had.
Right, what time are we going to eat?
Mark's in charge.
About three.
I figured we could go for a walk, work up an appetite. The park's very nice.
Oh, I'm more interested in the local pub.
Well, we could stop there on the way back. Right, I'll just go and get these open.
Oof, I'm not sure I can trust you with champagne after the effect it had on you Christmas morning.
Don't worry, you're safe. We're in company.
Yeah, it's never stopped you before.
I'm going to help Mark.
This place is lovely. They've got it looking really nice.
Yes.
Oh, the loo.
Top of the stairs.
Thanks.
Do you two really have to carry on like that?
Like what?
You're all over each other. It's embarrassing the hell out of Vic. Don't say you haven't noticed.
I'm sorry, yes. No, you're right. We're supposed to keep 3 feet apart and avoid all physical contact here.
Look, I'm not joking, Darren. Look, the atmosphere's tense enough without you two behaving like lovesick teenagers. Did you really have to bring her?
Yeah, Charlotte's my girlfriend.
Are you sure she isn't just a way for you to get a Victoria?
Sending me away, then?
Yep.
Pack your bags. You're on the next boat.
Right, well, I think I've got everything. Oh, I'm sorry to rush in and out like this, but we can have a good gab tomorrow. Yeah. So what are you doing today?
Nothing, really.
Aren't you seeing Luke?
We finished.
Casey, why didn't you say?
I don't want to talk about it, really.
Oh, I feel lost now. All I've done is go on about me and Nathan. You OK?
Yeah. You were right, I'm better off without him.
Well, he was a bit weird, wasn't he? Oh, it'll be for the best, you'll see. Listen, we'll talk about it tomorrow. If you fancy going into town, we can do some shopping and have some lunch.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Please. See you tomorrow, then.
See ya.
Nice surprise to come home to.
Well, talk about surprises. You weren't due back for days yet.
Well, I didn't like to think you'd been here all alone.
Thanks. Well, it looks as if you've been keeping busy.
Well, that's not the half of it. Wait till you see the kitchen.
Well, can't wait.
Hey, did you really cut your holiday short for me?
Partly. Although I did think I'd leave Margie and the girls on their own for a few days too. Also, there's something I'd like to see to on our Nicky's behalf.
Oh, yeah.
Well, never mind that. Let's go and inspect this kitchen.
Yeah, we'll get the kettle on. I bet you didn't get a decent cuppa in Madeira.
Say goodbye to me, Ma, for me.
Count yourself lucky that you don't have to do it yourself. At least this way you won't see the shame on her face when she finds out what you really are.
But Matt and Kelly, when are we going to see them?
You won't be seeing them. If you really care about them, you're no longer part of this family.
Da! Come on.
So how's Mark been about his mother?
It really upset him. She was in such a bad way towards the end.
At Christmas time as well.
So when's the funeral?
Well, we don't know until after the new year. Mark just wants to get over and done with, really.
He's looking well, though.
He's been having trouble picking things up, I'd heard.
He dropped a glass of juice, for God's sake. It wasn't anything serious.
Has he shown any other symptoms yet?
No, I told you, he's fine. He's as fit as any of the rest of us. You should mind your own business.
Oops. Guess that silence means I must be the topic of conversation.
You're only saying how well you look.
For someone who could be a complete wreck by next Christmas, you mean?
Mark.
Oh, that's not what we were saying at all.
No, I know, but let's be honest. It's what we're all thinking. I mean, here I am now pouring you all drinks. And just think, this time next year, I might not even be able to pour myself one.
Or you could be a picture of perfect health in 5 years' time, let alone one.
I doubt it. I think probably in a year or two, I'll be lucky if I can even feed and dress myself.
Not now, Mark, please.
Yep, I'm going to be relying on Vic for everything. Blowing my nose, wiping my bum, the lot. Cheers.
Just going to get some more drinks.
Oh, you've done a smashing job.
Oh, I'm glad you like it.
Oh. And everything's to hand?
It's ergonomically perfect. A place for everything and everything in its place.
It must have taken you days.
Not really. I finished it Christmas morning. I would have done it sooner, and I was giving Jimmy a hand.
And when are we going to find out what this top-secret project's all about, then?
Oh, not till midnight, New Year's Eve. Do you know, he's got me sworn to secrecy.
I think the pair of you are cracked.
So, how was your holiday, then?
Oh, really nice, thanks. It was so good to see Margie and the girls together again. Nikki was in good spirits. She's almost back to her old self.
Good. Let's hope it's permanent.
Well, I think it should be. As long as a certain person doesn't spoil it all for her.
Everyone's ready for another topper.
I've got another bottle in.
Charlotte was saying how much she likes the house.
Good.
I'm glad Darren brought her. I really, really like her.
Yeah, she's really nice.
I'm sorry, I was out of order in there.
It's okay, I understand. It must be hard for you at the moment, your mum and everything.
It's got nothing to do with my mum.
Look, it could be years before anything happens. You can't let it overshadow your life.
I can't help it. I just keep worrying about what it's going to be like for you as much as for me.
I'll be fine. Don't worry about me.
Well, how are you going to cope?
I'll manage.
Well, how about when it gets really bad? I'm just completely useless, wreck and in need of constant attention.
I know what to expect. I'm prepared for it.
But you'll be fed up, you'll be exhausted.
I can handle it, honestly.
You remember when Mum was in that hospital? Are you really going to be able to look after me when I end up in the same state that she ended up in?
Yeah.
Having to dress me and spoon feed me like a baby, day in, day out, week in, week out.
Yeah, of course.
Are you sure? Are you absolutely positive? Vic.
Yeah, of course I am. Come on, others are waiting. Are we gonna be okay? I know we are.
Yeah.
Underneath for ages, yeah? Am I supposed to thank you?
Do what you like.
Mum's always gone on at us to be polite. Please, thank you. Goodbye.
Yeah, she also taught us to tell the truth.
Haven't seen you telling the truth recently. She's asked you enough times what's been going on.
Yeah, well, I think too much of her to upset her.
Me too.
Well, you should have thought about that before you brought all this on yourself, shouldn't you? Or is it my mum's fault for getting to teach you not to be a rapist?
There's one thing Mum taught us above everything else. Forgiveness.
Yeah. Well, there are some things that you can't forgive. Anyone.
Are you really saying you never want to see me again?
Brilliant! Wicked. Thank you, Jackie. What a great present. Mm-hmm. I'll make sure I put them to good use.
Thanks, Jackie.
Vic says it was your favourite. Oh, Nathan tells me that the news of your engagement went down really, really well with his family. Yeah, they seem genuinely pleased for us.
It just goes to show what good taste I've got.
Yeah. Are we going for this walk then, or what?
A walk? Mm, that sounds healthy.
To the local.
No, we can still go to the park to get some fresh air.
Prefer some fresh beer.
Come on, tell me all about your Christmas. No. What?
Just want to make sure that you're all right. You seemed upset earlier.
I'm fine. Really, it was nothing.
It didn't look that way to me. I know when you're unhappy.
I just lost it for a moment, that's all. Things have been really, really heavy. You know, with Mark's mum, everything else.
I hate seeing you like this.
Come on, they're waiting.
Let them. We haven't even wished each other Merry Christmas yet.
Darren? OK,
Okay, let's go.
No, you go on ahead. I've got stuff to do.
No, just do it when we get back.
No, no, it's fine. Honestly, it won't take a second. On you go.
Okay, well, don't be too long, yeah? I want to work with you. Are you going to tell me what's going on with you and Luke? He's not himself at all.
I don't want to talk about it.
Oh, don't you? Well, I think I deserve an explanation over why you didn't show up for your Christmas dinner. Especially after I had the decency to invite you in the first place.
You're Luke's the only one who's got explaining to do.
What's that supposed to mean?
Ask him now.
What's the matter? Bored with him now, are you? Or do you just fancy another go with Ryan?
You've got no right to start having a go at me, not with a son like yours.
Come on, if you've got something to say, you spit it out.
I'm not going to be the one to tell you.
Victoria wanted to come back for you, but I insisted.
All right, thanks.
What's up?
No, just looking for something for a headache.
Yeah, well, two of these ought to do you.
What's the matter, Doc? You think I'm going to top myself?
No, of course not.
I'll tell you what, let's put your mind at rest.
Look, about before, nothing was going on.
Yeah, I know.
I saw Vic and I thought that she looked like things were getting to her a bit. I just wanted her to know that I'm there for it, for both of you. As a friend.
Yeah, thanks.
As time goes on, I think you're both going to need all of our support.
Do you think Vic's going to be able to cope when things get bad?
I don't know.
It's going to be a nightmare for her, isn't it?
It's a horrible disease. There's no denying it.
I'm just not sure, you know.
About what?
Whether I have the right to put her through it. Maybe I'm asking too much.
You're the only person that can answer that.
There really is no need for you to do this today, you know.
I just wish I'd finished it before you got back.
I think you've already done more than enough. Just a tick. I need a word with Neve Musgrove.
Okie dokie.
I want to talk to that lad of yours, Luke. There's something we need to sort out.
Can't you lay off him? He was found not guilty.
Then he should be put on trial again to make up for their mistake. We want justice for what he did.
What's going on?
Luke's being victimised, as usual.
Come on, don't be upsetting yourself.
Look, Neve, I understand you wanting to protect your son. You're a decent woman. But if he had any decency in him, he would have told you the truth by now, instead of letting you find out from somebody else.
Yeah, Luke's been telling the truth all along.
As he whacks. It's all lies. We know for certain now that he did it.
Oh, really? And how's that then?
He confessed to Nicky.
Is that what she's saying now? Well, Jessie, I feel really sorry for her.
Come on. Let's just go inside.
No, Joey, we've put up with this long enough. I am sick of my son being slandered.
Niamh,
please.
Why should we? We've got nothing to be ashamed of. Joey.
My God. You know, don't you?
Know what?
That your son raped our Nicky.
And, 3 pints of lager, please.
Mark seemed edgy earlier. Do you think he'd be okay?
His mother's death's affected him more than he's admitting. It's obviously making him think about himself, but instead of talking about it, he's keeping it all inside.
Well, he seems prepared for what's gonna happen.
All he seems to go on about at the moment is how I'm gonna deal with it. It's like his main worry is that I'm not gonna be able to handle it when things get tough.
And you think you will?
I keep reading about all these people that devote their lives to caring. You know, they're total heroes. They sacrifice everything to look after the people they love constantly, no matter what. I just worry whether I've got it in me to be like them.
And I'm sure those people have the same fears too.
Yeah, but can I overcome them? I'm so selfish.
You'll be fine. You've got friends and family. And it will all help you through it.
I'm the one that's really got to keep it all together.
You've got it in you, you just don't realise. Look, once you set your mind to something, you usually get it. This is no different, honestly. You'll be there for Mark and we'll be there for you.
Can I have another drink, please, seeing as you didn't save me any champagne back at the house?
Sorry, I drank yours.
And mine and Charlotte.
Listen, I called down to the flat before, and Katie told me that I had Lucas's place up.
Well, that's good news, isn't it?
Yeah, but I thought they'd go to the evening. Well, she's really upset, but she didn't seem to want to talk about it.
Well, you've warned her off him enough times. I mean, maybe she's just uncomfortable discussing him after that.
I don't know, there seems to be something else that she wasn't telling me.
Cheers. Mark's got a bit of a headache. He's going to catch us up.
Oh, right.
He's in a strange mood.
Well, it wouldn't be after the last few months he's had.
Yeah, I don't know how I'd be coping if I was in his position.
My son's a rapist.
Niamh. Look, love.
How long have you all known?
Christmas Day. Luke admitted it to Katie.
And you?
When I came home from work, he just admitted to Ryan.
Where is he now? I've had enough of the lies and the deceit.
He's gone to Ireland.
Ireland?
Yeah. She'll be boarding the boat about now.
Why dare you keep this from me? Give me the keys!
Where are you going?
To sort this out.
Wait!
Just leave me alone, Joey, and don't you dare try and stop me!
Sounds like you had a good Christmas, then.
Oh, yeah. We had a great laugh.
Yeah, especially at your carol singing.
Hey, your mum says I have a lovely voice, better than yours, actually.
That's not hard.
So your family looking forward to it?
Oh, Mum just wants to get started with all the organising. But I've warned her she's not taking over. This is mine and Jackie's day.
Aww.
Are you okay?
Yeah. Yeah, it's feeling a bit crook. I can need the little boy's room.
So what's the plan for this New Year's Eve?
Well, you're all welcome to come to the club unless you've got other plans.
I think Mark and I are just going to be spending it together.
Oh, that's a bit dull, isn't it? Biggest party of the century and you're sitting in. We should all be together.
Yeah, but I want it to be special for him. Out of all of us, this New Year's Eve's going to mean the most to him, and us spending it alone together just seems like the right thing to do.
Aww. Where's Darren? He's been gone ages. Probably got locked in the toilet.
More likely throwing up. He never could hold his drink.
Yes. That's
true.
Mark! Come on, mate, you're lagging behind. Mark!
Luke.
I never meant for things to happen the way they did.
It is true.
I'm so sorry.
You swore to me. I believed you.
Look,
I'm going. I'll be out of your lives forever.
So that's it? You're just gonna leave without saying goodbye? No explanation or anything?
I wanted to see you. I realized I couldn't face you.
Well, here I am, and now I know the truth. I just can't understand how you would have done something like that.
I know.
And then lied to us and kept on lying.
I hated myself. I swear I did. All the way through it, I just despised myself.
Yeah, well, you led me to believe that you were innocent, that you were as much a victim as Nikki. How could you do that?
Don't worry. You'll never have to see me again.
Do you really think I could live with that? Look, I could just forget you ever existed.
Stop
do you really
that.
Think I could?
Stop it.
Do you? Do you? You're coming home until I decide what's happening.
What's going on?
Mark! Mark! Darren! Darren, what's happening with Mark?
He must have fallen down the stairs. I'm sorry. I arrived too late.
Did you even have a chance to say goodbye?
Imagine if you found out if you have taken ecstasy.
What?
Next time we see the sun, it'll be the new millennium.
I need to tell you how badly I feel. I think I might be having contractions.
Surely we can't be past it already.
Well, I hope not. I'm still waiting to hit me prime.
Let's get it boxed off.
The clock is ticking.
And we pay a New Year's Eve visit to Brookside tomorrow at 8.
We were all just round the corner in the pub having a laugh when it happened.
Broken neck is terrible.
Do you think he slipped or what? There's going to be some kind of inquest.
How's Victoria?
Oh, she's in bits. Dad and Nathan are sorting out all the arrangements for her.
She's going to need all the support she can get.
Yeah, well, we're going to be staying with her for the next few days. So I won't be coming to the club tonight, if that's okay with you.
Oh, don't worry about it.
We're just going to spend the night with Victoria.
Mm.
Will you be coming tonight?
Well, Max is really keen, but it depends whether we can get a babysitter or not.
Oh. So I'll be running the place on my own, then?
Nah, I'd rather just drink. I don't need pills.
How do you know if you haven't tried them? Look, the ones he's got for tonight are supposed to be boss. He gave one of the barmaids one, and she says it's the best buzz she's ever had. So are you up for it?
I don't know.
Oh, come on, what have you got to lose? Tonight of all nights.
I might have an half.
You're going to end up taking it all now, and the best night of your life.
Me one.
No, do your own.
You working tonight?
Yeah, why?
Well, my mate wants some tickets and I want to go too.
You? Behave.
Why not? Ashley's been loads of times. She reckons the bouncers let anyone in.
Not you. Too young.
Loads of girls been in my year. Anyway, they reckon it's dead easy if you wear the right clothes and makeup. And anyway, you can get us in for nothing.
No, I can't. And if I did anyway, which I don't, what do you want your dad to do? He'd kill me.
Imagine if he found out if you were taking ecstasy.
What?
Anyone in?
Gemma Johnson plus two, if you don't want my dad to find out. Am I still all right for lift Ashley's after?
Yeah, you are, babe.
What, that supermarket was hectic. People are mad.
What? Just something we said.
What's up with them?
Obviously planning their big night out.
Yeah.
I doubt he got that kind of service in prison.
Hey, this is coming together, isn't it? Shame I won't be here for the big unveiling at midnight.
What makes you think you're invited?
Oh, I'm probably busy at the club anyway.
Can't wait till the two musketeers find out that you're turning their club into an under-12 rave.
They're not even coming tonight. Besides, neither of them are even interested in the place.
Well, they will be when they find out it's full of underage kids off their box, thanks to you.
That's the last bit of daylight of the 20th century there. Next time we see the sun, it'll be the new millennium.
If you feel anything, ring me straight away, OK?
OK.
Hopefully I'll be done by midnight. Everyone will be going to the club or to parties, so cleaning the bar won't take too long.
Hey, if people had any sense, they'd all be staying home tonight. Who knows what could happen come midnight?
Nothing's gonna happen, Dad.
Oh, no. You are all gonna be laughing on the other side of your faces tomorrow. You know, I reckon that's why Anthea went to her sister's, just so she doesn't have to face me when I'm proved right.
You should have gone with Anthea, Ron.
No way, love. I am staying put. Come midnight, I'm going to be prepared and safe.
Right, see you later.
See you.
Ah, well, there it goes till the next millennium. Let's just hope when daybreak does come, there's something left for the sun to shine down on.
Why did you leave the pub early and go back to him?
I just had a feeling. I can't explain it. I just sensed something might be up.
Do you think he died hating me?
No. Of course he didn't.
He died knowing I wasn't going to be able to cope.
Jessie.
Well?
I'm sorry to bother you. I was wondering whether I could have a word.
How about rapist? Or guilty?
I just need the chance to apologize for everything.
It's a bit late for that. Just leave us alone.
No, please. I need to tell you how badly I feel. I'm so sorry. Please believe me, I am.
Yes, they are absolutely spot on, Raimondo. You are the tops, man.
Oh, there's nothing to it, really.
So you getting us in later, over?
No chance.
Dad!
Okay, okay. I'll put you on the list. But if your dad ever finds out you're in there, it's got nothing to do with me, okay? Now listen, just say one of your mates gave you a ticket, okay?
I'm coming, you lady.
And out with all the stuff. Thought you'd just stay in it. Not a party or anything, is it?
No, just some new things. Can we go now?
Yeah, cool. Hey, listen, guys, if you're gone by the time I get back, have a good night, innit? Be careful.
Hey, don't get too excited watching the telly, eh?
Yeah, see you next century.
See you later.
When I look back now, I realise just how much of a fool I've been. I should have known it was Luke, shouldn't I?
Sometimes we see only what we choose to. I should have realised much earlier that Greg was carrying on with his fancy piece. When I did find out, I couldn't believe I'd missed it.
When Luke was first accused, I couldn't believe it. I didn't think my wee boy was capable of doing something like that, you know, something so appalling.
But he was.
It makes me feel so sick. I get so angry when I think about it. My son, my flesh and blood. Shame isn't a strong enough word for it.
But he is still your son.
Yeah. Joey can't understand that, or Ryan. They just want to send him away, you know, punish him for it.
He deserves it.
Sometimes I want him to suffer. Really suffer for it. But then there's another part of me that wants to comfort him and just look after him.
You're his mother. That's natural. But only you can decide what to do. And more importantly, whether or not you can live with it.
If I do stand by him, I don't think Joey could handle it. The others don't even know yet. I mean, Kelly's still virtually a child. How's she going to deal with it?
Knowing what he's done, you've got to decide whether or not you can stand by him.
Apart from what he did to Nikki, he lied to me all that time. You know, he betrayed me on purpose. That really hurts.
You can forgive the betrayal. You can forgive them anything when they're your own. I should know. The way I put up with Greg cheating on Margie without telling her. But what your lad's done. Oh, I don't know. Only you can decide whether or not you can forgive him.
I reckon all this comes from when I was a Boy Scout as a kid. You know, be prepared and all that stuff.
Ron?
Ah, well, at least we'll be able to see what we're doing tonight. You know, all this reminds me of the 70s. The power cuts, 3-day week, the winter of discontent. Of course, you wouldn't remember that. It's long before your time. I remember the Lecky used to go off at 10 on weekdays. It was bread strikes, shortages. Mind you, that's nothing compared to what this millennium bug's gonna cause. What's the matter, love? You look awful.
I think you might be having contractions.
What? What, you mean the baby might be on its way?
I'll have to get to hospital.
Oh, hang on, love, hang on. Do you think that's wise? I mean, you never know what might happen tonight.
Ron!
But I'm just thinking of you, that's all. You know, the hospital mightn't be safe.
Just get me an ambulance, will you?
Yeah. Just keep breathing, look, keep breathing. Everything's all right.
Where's Mike? What's keeping him?
Just you relax, he'll be here any minute. Bags of time yet.
I keep asking myself over and over, will I even be able to bear being near to Luke, knowing what he did, what he's capable of? I just keep thinking about what Nikki's been through.
She didn't lose her virginity. She had it stolen. He's ruined our Nikki's life, and I think he's going to ruin yours as well.
But I couldn't possibly turn my back on him. It wouldn't be right, would it?
Everything I've ever believed in tells me that we should forgive. But I can't find any forgiveness in my heart for him. No matter how hard I try or what my faith says.
So what would you think if I stood by him?
Hey, won't be able to move in the swan tonight or get saved.
No, you have to pay in a score to get in as well. Cheers, mate.
Cheers, mate. And imagine town. I mean, anywhere that is open will cost you a bum. I'll just be packed with kids and all that, you know.
I know. And everyone's going to be walking home tonight, mate, because you're going to have no chance of getting a taxi. Ho, ho, ho.
Unemployed. I told them to stuff it. You off back home south, then?
How sad are we, eh?
Very.
Biggest night ever. And we're stuck in watching films we've already seen and drinking the quickies cheapest ale.
We're getting older, what? Children can't be past it already.
Well, I hope not. I'm still waiting to hit me prime.
Is your clothes?
Yeah.
There you are. How are you feeling?
Just keep thinking of the last time I saw him. I didn't even have a chance to say goodbye.
No.
So all being well, we'll be finished just in time. The electrics are checked and ready.
What do you need electricity for?
Ha-ha! You just have to wait and see.
What are you two like with all this secrecy?
We're onto the home straight, kidder. Let's get it boxed off.
The clock is ticking.
Oh, thank God.
All right, don't panic. The midwife said it's going to be hours yet.
Well, I knew that. It was obvious when we arrived. I'm more bothered about getting home. There's no way I want to be out of our house at midnight, especially in a hospital. Who knows what could go wrong? Computers probably run everything in this place. We could be swamped with a dangerous virus.
Behave yourself, will you?
Yeah, well, you see, come 12 o'clock. I'm going.
You can't leave me, Dad.
But we could be sat around here for hours. No, the quicker I'm safely home, the better.
Look, forget all that. I need you here. Oh, come on, this is me first kid. What if anything goes wrong?
But what will I do if I stay here?
Me head in, probably, but I'd still rather have you here. Oh, you, me Dad, come on, please.
OK, but I'm going by 11:30, Michael, at the very latest.
Cheers, Pops.
You should have just left him on the boat. It's what he wanted, and it was the best thing to do.
That's not the solution.
Then what is? No, Grandad, no, there's nothing to worry about. Yeah, we'll tell you all about it when we get there. Yes, yes, I know. Look, I'm going to have to go, Grandad. Yeah, ta-ra.
This has gone on long enough. Go and get your brother. Go on.
What are we going to do? Have a party?
Hey, I didn't, all right.
Who's that over there of your mates?
I don't know, some lad. Mind your own business anyway. We're off for a dance. Fancy it.
Just be careful, you. There's too many divvies in here.
Not soft, you know.
Can't believe she's in here now. My dad would go mad if he found out. I should have gone to cream with Jerome.
You wouldn't have got a ticket. And anyway, it's going to be sound in here later on. You still up for that, eh?
Not of our Gemma around, no.
You bricking it?
I'd rather spend my money on ale.
Go away, you gimp.
Get lost. Anyway, Mona won't order her over there, so I'll see you later.
Hey, no time to be standing around talking tonight. Tim, can you go downstairs and make sure the fridge is filled with bottled water? This lot aren't even touching the beer.
I wonder why.
Few younger ones in here, but we're like 30, well, 20 years older than everyone.
What's Willie Nick here for a school disco?
Well, it's not that bad.
Oh, isn't it? Where did I speak to Lindsay?
Did you have to interrogate that midwife about the millennium bug nonsense? I felt lost.
Hey, if you're gonna have your baby here tonight of all nights, you should at least know if they're prepared. And anyway, don't be worrying. I won't be embarrassing you much longer. I'll be on my way in a minute.
What, so you're willing to miss the birth of your first grandchild because of some stupid scare stories?
No, I just don't want to be hanging around here for hours, that's all. And anyway, they're not stupid scare stories.
Well, the midwife did say it was going to be a slow labour. Probably won't have it till tomorrow anyway. You can come back in the morning.
That's if we're all still here in the morning.
for the last time that nothing is going to happen.
Oh, my God. It started.
In your mouth.
Don't be silly. Haven't you took yours yet?
Are you off your head? That could have been anything you just took.
I'll get lost, Leo.
OK, but hurry up. I think the shock's brought the contractions on again. They're coming quicker all the time. You all right, Mitch? You OK?
It's broke! It's broke! Yeah, you all laughed at me, didn't you? But I told you so.
You just said yourself, it's just a fault with the electrics. It's not even midnight yet.
Yeah, but it soon will be. And we're going to be stuck in here when it all goes off. We might end up being the only ones left alive.
Nothing is going to happen.
We just shut up, both of you.
Rich, it's going to be okay. They'll have us all to be here soon. It's all right.
They're getting worse.
You okay, Rich? Right. Come on, will you?
Everything's
going
to be okay. All right?
Please, God. I don't want to die.
Lindsay, what the hell's going on?
Well, it looks to me like a club full of paying customers.
Underage kids, you mean? This isn't what we set out to rob.
But it's successful.
Half of these are nowhere near old enough to be in a nightclub, Lindsay.
Mitch, the security staff are told to use the discretion.
Lindsay, they should be told to use their eyes as well. I mean, look around you, half of these are on something.
There doesn't seem to be much beer being drunk. It's all soft drinks and water.
I know that, but there's a lot of profit in it.
I'll certainly be talking to Jackie about this. Come on, Max, we're leaving.
Right, then.
Shall we get off then?
No, I want to look for our Leo. The state some of these are in order to make sure he's not on anything.
Oh, Leo? No, he wouldn't.
Hey, you're not going to believe this. Your dad's standing at the top bar with Sinbad.
Oh, no, you're joking.
No, you're going to have to get her out of here.
Oh, she's off a cake. Can't you try and keep him away? I'm not going to want to dance, Hardy.
Well, I can't. I've got Lindsay on my case. You're going to have to.
I'm not taking my eyes off here for one second. Some shady gets in here. And remember what happened to Nicky Shadwick?
All right, I'll do my best. Look at the state of her. You just know I'm going to get the blame for this.
There is no way I'm staying in the same house as that lying rapist.
He's our son. And I won't abandon him, whatever you decide to do.
Rach, it's all right.
It's not all right! I'm the baby in the lift!
It's too late. I think it's coming. You're going to have to keep telling me what to do.
Oh, my God.
Could be the last thing you do this century, that.
Quick! Grab one each!
Oh, now, that's what I call timing. Come on, Rach.
I didn't think we'd finish it in time.
I didn't think I'd get back from work in time.
So this is finally it, eh?
Yeah. Who'd have believed it, eh, kids?
I meant the end of the century and the dawning of a new one.
Yeah, come on. I'll open the champers. I want you to do the honours, Jack.
How do you mean?
There you go. You're unveiling it.
Now, all you got to do is flick that switch on my cue. Got it?
Yeah.
Right, come on, kidders. 10.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
You should
bear down, okay? It's all right.
You're all right, love.
You're all right.
2, 1,
Happy New Year! It's a girl. It's a girl.
Well done. Absolutely fantastic.
Joey. Please, Joey Witt.
You've made your decision. If you're standing by him, then our marriage is over.
Happy New Year, Joey! All the best!
tapping songs about murder and the bubonic plague, and a view that the French should have got a red card at the Battle of Hastings. Animated history according to Millennium the Musical. Next.
Dad, you can't just get off like this. Well, we need to sort this out.
Your mother's determined to stand by him.
So we have to be the ones to make her see sense. Come on. Please.
Well, look at them, Ray.
To the round the back, brought her to the front. Yeah. Now, too,
do you, I don't know what he was doing.
Hey, good, eh, lads? What do you think? Charming. How impressive, isn't it, people?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
What's going on, eh? We've been sat in that port waiting for you, lot. He's gone mad because you didn't say enough.
Yeah, we're sorry.
What do you think you're playing at?
Not now, Alec.
You better have a damn good reason for ruining everybody's night.
We can explain, Dad. It's just...
Luke's admitted to raping Nicky Chadwick. So New Year's Eve celebrations was the last thing in our mind.
What?
You're joking. Is this true?
Get out the way, will you?
What's happened?
She just collapsed.
Gemma! Gemma!
We need to get her to the Aussie.
She's collapsed. Phone ambulance.
Get her outside.
Phone ambulance first on your mobile.
I will when she's off the premises.
What?
Get her outside.
We need to get to the hospital.
Now? Come on, get her outside.
Has anyone got a mobile?
Are you listening to me? I don't want anyone getting carried out of here. They'll shut the place.
Hurry up! Hello, ambulance, please. Yeah, the new Millennium Club. Manor Park.
So they're both fine?
Yeah, great, no problems.
Ah, good. My little granddaughter, eh?
Yeah, she's beautiful. The image of a mother.
I'm still trying to calm down.
No, it was mad, wasn't it? Hey, what happened to your Millennium Meltdown?
I'll forget all that. Besides, we're all still here. And anyway, I'm more interested in that little baby girl and what a way to start a century, eh?
I better get back in. Won't be long.
You can't just run away from things. Let's get in there and try to sort this whole bloody mess out. Come on, lad, half the neighbourhood's watching. Let's go inside.
The thought of being in the same house as that.
Yeah, but Grandad's right.
Okay. But both of you have got to help me convince her that Luke's gone is the only way we're going to sort this whole mess out.
Well, I'm with you on this one.
Yeah, too right. He's got to get off. And the sooner the better.
Yeah, like tonight.
Hey, Jess, I've got the nice idea here. Let's park ourselves.
Thanks, Bob. Well, the little one's okay.
Yeah, they're fast asleep. Do you know what? I would have thought all the fireworks and the noise would have woken them up, but they're dead to the wheels.
Well, they see through anything, kids.
Yeah, even the Musgroves having a go at each other. Do you know what? There's definitely something going on over there.
Yes, all right. Thank you very much. Less of the nosing. Come on, what about this? Amazing, innit?
No, I told you. I mean, it's very nice, but I just never expected the period to come up with something so big.
Me neither.
I mean,
mean, look, sis, it's huge.
Yeah.
I hope the neighbours don't mind you.
Oh.
Well, we're not going to complain, are we?
No, but there's some round here who would.
Well, I don't see why anyone should disapprove. I mean, it looks great.
And I'll tell you something. I'll bet you there aren't many streets round here that have got their own Millennium Arch.
Hey, Jim, is it safe?
I mean, it's not going to topple over or anything, is it?
Oh, don't be daft, of course it's not.
Well,
oh.
You say that now, but what if a big gust of wind comes along?
Oh, love, the kids could be out playing.
Well, don't worry, I've made sure it's well supported. A hurricane wouldn't be able to shift that beauty.
See? When it comes to something like this, Raimundo is your man. He is the technical genius behind the whole project. I wouldn't have been able to do it without him.
It's nothing, really.
Ray, you're joking, aren't you? The way you worked on that, you worked like a Trojan kid.
It was no bother, honestly.
Oh, give over. Hey, what a sight. What an achievement!
I'm looking for our Leo. That's if he's still here. Leo!
Oh, he's probably on the dance floor letting it all hang out or something. Oh, let's get out of here. I feel like an outlive.
Hey, we've had enough. We're getting off. It's like being out of school disco here, Linz.
This is a club and these are clubbers.
We've got a situation. Some kid's collapsed and she looks way too young to be in here.
What's happened to her?
A dodgy tablet. I wanted her out, but that mouthy barman of yours insisted on calling an ambulance.
It's a disgrace, that is. You're talking about someone's child here. You should be ashamed of yourself.
Just keep out of it, eh? This has nothing to do with
it. Turn the lights on, the music off. It's Gemma.
Gemma.
She's collapsed. What's she doing here?
Oh, my God. I tell a DJ to turn the music off and I want the lights up.
But...
now! How could we have come to Paul's with this hanging over us?
Could have at least told me what was going on.
And spoil your New Year's Eve.
It's points anyway.
How can you show your face, you?
No, Dad!
If you know what's good for you, you pack your bags.
Already tried sending him away.
Should make sure he goes this time.
What a new year.
Please, everyone.
This time, make sure he doesn't come back.
What is this? Some kind of family court? All the side of my punishment, are you?
Like you need punishing. I tell you what, I was glad when them fellas inside give you the good hiding. It's what you just deserved.
I've had enough of this. I'm not sticking round here.
No, you don't.
For crying out loud, do us all a favour. Just let him go.
Here, here.
No way. Just stop it, will you? What did you do, Renee?
Oh, Kel, I just...
How could you do something like that? You're my brother, and I believed you all along. You managed to convince Emily, didn't I? That her own sister might have got it all wrong.
I'm sorry, Kel.
When Nicky said it was you, I didn't believe her. It couldn't have been. I thought some weirdo had sneaked into a room or something. But not you. I knew it wasn't you. Not my brother.
I'm sorry, Kel.
I remember being so scared. Because whoever did it was still out there. I knew the police weren't going to be looking for anyone because they already had you locked up. But you were innocent, weren't you, Luke? I remember being so frightened in case he came back. But I had nothing to worry about, did I?
I hope you're proud of yourself.
How can you even touch him after what he's done?
Doesn't deserve any pity. He shouldn't even be here.
I can't handle this.
Lou, take a look at what this is doing to your family.
I know what he did was horrendous, but everybody needs the chance to put things right.
What's he going to do? Unrape Nicky.
He's sorry, I know he is. And if I can forgive him, then we all can.
The punters are going mad. You can't close on New Year's Eve just because some stupid kid's copped for a dud E.
I know that kid. And what if someone else had to take him one, eh? We could have had people collapsing all over the place.
This isn't good for business.
And neither is some blade selling dodgy tabs.
Gemma.
How can you let children into a nightclub? You saw a lion there, you wouldn't even call an ambulance.
Mick, let's go.
You better pray that she's all right.
Hey, Jim, I think we've seen the new year in now, love. We're freezing.
And you've messed with those lights long enough.
All right, we're just checking that these are spot on. Ha! Ray! Spot on!
You're not leaving them on all night, are you?
Of course I am.
What about the Lecky Bill? Lighting the old Liverpool that cost us a fortune?
It's the Millennium! Tomorrow night when I go to bed, I'll turn them off.
Right. Thanks for a nice time.
Oh, right, love, you going?
Yep, Happy New Year.
Oh, Happy New Year to you.
We'll see you tomorrow.
Oh, thanks.
Well done.
Hey, Raimundo. I couldn't have done it without you, mate. All the best, eh?
Oh, well, rubbish, rubbish. Ta-da, then.
See ya. Good night, love. Right. Come on, Jimmy. Let's get inside.
Yeah, in a minute, love, in a minute.
Jimmy, you can't stand out here looking at us. It's all nice.
Come here.
What?
There's something I want to show you.
I've seen it.
No, you haven't had a proper look, have you? Not close up, look. See?
God, that's a picture of me, Dad.
Yeah, it's sort of dedicated to him.
Oh, that's really nice of you. But you didn't get on with him.
You mean he hated me guts because I was a good-for-nothing, lazy nomad who stole his little girl away from him?
Wasn't little, was I? So why me, Dad?
Well, I thought I'd mark the life of a good, honest working man. You know, someone who took care of his family, never stepped out of line, never did anything out of the ordinary except live his life. Someone who treated others with respect. And, well, I don't know, just got on with it.
Jimmy, that's lovely.
You know, love, all these politicians and footballers, actors even, they're always getting all sorts of awards and honours, aren't they, eh? Not to mention boosters. That's all I get out, fella. He gets nothing. Well, we've got this for him now. For the millions like him.
What do you mean they don't know the exact time she was born? I can tell them it was bang on midnight. I know that. This watch is exact. I set it to the speaking clock this morning.
Yeah, but because she was born on a lift, they can't register it at exactly midnight. It's a minute or so after.
Michael, son, you're going to miss out on all kinds of freebies. That little one is the genuine millennium baby. You want to get onto the papers and they tell you...
Yeah. Never mind all that. Just look at her.
We wouldn't be having this now if she'd just left him on that boat.
Look at him. It's obvious that he doesn't want to be here.
Well, I can't see how we can stay.
I know this has all come as a bit of a shock, love. We're just going to have to pull together and get through it.
Has all the shouting stopped now? I hope the rest of the century isn't going to be like this.
Maybe now we can start talking things through, you know, stop bawling at each other.
I can't see what there is to talk about. No matter what you say, we can't put up with a rapist in the family. He's got to go.
This is your grandson you're talking about.
By standing by him, you're just going to tear this family apart. What's that going to achieve?
Yeah, but it won't be me that splits us up.
Yes, it will. Because I'm not hanging around as long as he's here.
Then that's your choice. No one's forcing you to go.
Yes, they are. You! If he stays, I'm off. And it won't just be me that you're losing. It'll be Leah and all. So you're going to miss out on seeing your granddaughter grow up as well.
I don't know.
Has she come round yet?
They've put on a ventilator.
Oh, no.
Doctor said that's normal for drug poisons. Drugs? My little Gemma, she's still only a child.
All right, Mick. She's going to be okay.
What was she doing in there?
She's with her mates.
You should have marched her out as soon as you saw her.
Yeah, I know that now. She just kept on telling me to get lost and that she was all right. I was keeping an eye on her and she just collapsed.
Yeah, it's not Leo's fault.
Whose fault is it then? Yours? You were working there. She shouldn't have even been in there.
All right, Mick, save it. It's Lindsay Corkill you should be having a go at.
Right, thanks for coming. I'll tell you called.
Well?
They want Jackie to go down the station for a chat to review the club's drugs and age policies. Well, she's the licensee.
Well, they always do that after someone's collapsed. It's nothing to worry about.
There's a little girl lying in hospital. Poisoned by some of the crappy gear you were supposed to keep out of this place.
I can't help it if some little squirt comes in here with a few dodgy tablets he wants to palm off on kids stupid enough to buy them.
I know that kid. Her family's neighbours of ours.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry. It couldn't be helped and all that. But there was no need to kick everyone out. That can't have done business much good.
I had no choice but to close the club down. It's going to be hard enough facing her family as it is. Well, not to mention mine.
Yeah, well, people aren't going to want to come back to a club where they had a crap New Year, are they?
Well, I don't care. I'm more worried about Gemma Johnson in hospital.
Well, you want to worry about the future of your club. I'm off to find a party. See ya.
Ryan, you can't be serious about this.
You know what you have to do to make me stay.
If you don't, I'll be off next. Because I tell you what, I'm not hanging around either.
Grandad!
I'm sorry, love, but your mother isn't doing any choice.
Don't be blaming me. I'm not forcing anyone out. In fact, I'm the only one who's trying to keep us all together.
So if we all stay here, like a big, happy family, what are you going to do if Kelly wants one of her friends over to stay? You're going to be okay with that?
That's not fair.
Drugging someone and raping them is not fair.
And he would never do it again.
Why? Because the lying little git told you he wouldn't?
I'm going to get the rest of me stuff, and then I'm going.
Niamh, come on. This family's falling to pieces because of him. Is he worth that?
Well, is the clap clinic open tonight, then, is it?
Hey, you. Our Gemma's in there fighting for her life, so keep your pathetic jokes to yourself.
I'm sorry, Mac, I didn't know. Is she going to be all right?
We don't know yet.
I'm just on a bit of a high. I'm a granddad again. Rachel's had a little girl.
How is she?
Oh, well, they're both fine. The birth was a bit of a to-do, but everything's turned out great.
All right. What are you doing here?
Our Gemma collapsed in the Millennium Club.
A little Gemma?
I know, I can't believe it myself. Such a thing, so...
Drugs?
Anyway, Mike, congratulations. Just make sure you look after her, eh?
Cheers, Mick. I hope Gemma's OK. What weight was the baby? 7 pounds, 11. I rang you before to let you know, but there was no answer. Do you want to come and see them?
Can I?
Yeah, of course.
Hey, listen, Mick, I hope your Gemma's going to be OK.
Cheers. Hope your Mike knows what he's letting himself in for, eh?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Bye then, Mum.
There's no need for this, Ryan.
Yeah, there is.
Come on, Niamh. You can stop this.
Go into the kitchen, please, Luke.
You should be sending him further than that.
You understand, I've never forgiven myself for giving him up when he was a baby. And perhaps now, at long last, I can make up for that by standing by him when he really needs me.
No matter what that does to the rest of the family.
Joey, I've tried hard enough to keep this family together in the past, and I'll keep on trying, but I'm not prepared to send Luke away. So if anyone goes, it's up to them. But it won't be me splitting us up.
You sure about this?
Positive.
I was just kidding myself, thinking I could ever leave you. You've always stood by me through the bad times. Looks like it's my turn to stand by you. I can't imagine life without you.
What about Luke?
Well, it's not going to be easy. She might be able to forgive him, but there's no way I'll ever be able to.
And Ryan, can you talk him out of going?
Don't think it's going to do any good.
Take care of yourself.
Try and stay out of trouble, eh?
I'm not promising anything.
Your mother just wanted me to ask you that.
My mum knows what she has to do to make me stay. It's up to her now.
Yeah, well, we all know how stubborn she can be. It's probably where you get it from.
Anyway, I better be off.
Where are you headed?
See Abby and Leah. Take you from there. I'll get the car back to you as soon as I can.
There's no need. You keep it.
Eh? I can't do that.
It's yours. Anyway, you're going to need to earn some money if you want to provide for the little one.
Thanks, Dad.
hope things go okay for you, boy. Don't be too hard on your mother. She's only doing what she thinks is for the best.
I know. But this time, she's got it so wrong.
Goodbye, son. Good luck.
See you, right.
Take care, lad.
Would you like to come through, please?
Don't worry, son, it'll be okay.
I'll never forgive myself if anything happens to me, you know.
It's not your fault you took it.
Yeah, but it was us who helped get it in the first place. Dad's gonna kill us when he finds out.
Hey, let's just keep that quiet, eh? Hopefully she won't say anything.
She mightn't be able to.
Don't be saying that.
How is she?
I don't know yet. My dad's only just gone in.
You should see Rachel's baby. She's gorgeous. Spit of a mum.
Is Rachel okay?
Yeah, she's whacked out, but she's made up.
Gonna be all right.
There's no change. She's not responding to treatment.
I thought you were supposed to be clearing up, not saying good night to it.
All right. I'm just having one last look.
Right, we'll get these chairs in, Frank. And why did I say put the kettle on? Hey. Do you know, I'm parched. There must be all the champagne.
Oh.
Oh. Hiya. Happy New Year, love.
I can't believe the size of this.
I know. Hey, what are you doing here? I thought you'd be back in the early hours.
Oh, there's a bit of trouble at the club. We had to close.
Why? What happened?
Oh, someone collapsed. They were taken into hospital. Dodgy ecstasy, they reckoned.
Oh, in your club? I didn't think it was that type of place.
All clubs are that type of place these days, Mum.
That's terrible.
It gets worse. It was Gemma Johnson that collapsed.
No. Little Gemma, she's only a child.
Well, I don't know if she managed to get in, but she did. She's still in intensive care.
Oh, love. Ah, come.
You must be tired, sweetheart.
We're never going to see our Ryan again, Mum.
Yeah, of course we will.
I'm gonna go and get my head down.
So you're proud of yourself now you forced your brother out the house?
Okay, Dad.
I'll see you in the morning.
Yeah, and you can do us all a favour. Don't wake up.
Dad!
Well, have you thought what life's gonna be like from now on? At least over the past year we could look the neighbours in the face because we believed he was innocent, but now...
Look, will you all just stop this stupid bickering? I'm gonna be getting off myself if this carries on.
Well, I'm definitely not sticking around. I'm off to our Paul's tomorrow. I can't face Jesse Shadwick or Nicky knowing what he's done.
Please yourselves.
I'm crying out loud, Nee, if there's going to be no one left.
There's only one thing for it. We'll have to move away. We're going to have to go back to Ireland.
Eddie's dead class, that, isn't he?
Dead off.
What are you doing home so early?
Oh, Jimmy, you'll never guess what happened in the club tonight. What?
Then go ahead, what?
Well, Mick's little Gemma had to be taken to Ozzy because they think she's taken something as her age. What the hell was that for? Jimmy!
Just drive, okay?
Because the law never punished you for what you did. So
So maybe this is God's way of making you pay.
Hey, you get out here now.
Just leave.
Oh, get out!
This is the real world, all right?
No, it's not all right. It's all wrong. It's all wrong.
Next on Four, a spectacular start for a new series of Driven, with some surprising news about the look of the new Mini.
Yeah, but where to?
I don't care. Somewhere where the lynch mob won't be after me blood. Lindsay!
Can I go and say goodbye to Leo now?
No way. When we leave this house, I want no one to know where he's going, okay?
I can't just disappear on him, Mum.
Well, like it or not, love, that's just what we're all doing. Sure, your dad can't even give his notice at the garage. Nor Luke, nor me at my job. How do you think we feel?
It's not fair.
No, it isn't. I know, not by a long way, but it's just the way it is.
I hate her, Luke.
Collecting up the last of my bits and pieces, then I'll be on my way.
I wish you'd come with us, Dad.
Couldn't handle the shame. Not living that close to the lad.
You'll look after yourself properly, won't you?
That'd be all right. I'll just sort out some new digs. Paul'll see me right till then.
We'll miss you, no?
I miss you and all. I mean, regardless of everything, you're still my daughter.
You all packed?
All packed, yeah. But I'm not going to go with you either.
Matt, we should be sticking together through this.
I phoned Bosco and he said I could go round and stay in his. But I didn't tell him the truth. I said just were kicking me out.
Spoke to Vic again on the phone. Third time today. Her head's all over the place.
Is her sister still staying with her?
She goes home today.
Come on, answer, will you?
You okay?
I will be when I finally get older, Lindsay.
Must have been awkward, you staying there.
It was okay.
But not easy.
I slept on the couch. It's ridiculous, isn't it? I mean, this is the woman I was ready to ask to marry me a couple of months ago.
Yeah, you even had the ring.
I know. I mean, if I had asked her to marry me, then what? Well, what if she'd said yes? Do you think she'd have gone back to Mark?
No, I doubt it.
Of course she wouldn't. She wouldn't have felt duty-bound to go back to him. It would have just been an ex-husband who was ill.
Look, I know it's tough, mate, but there's a lot of if-onlys in what you're saying.
Yeah, yeah. And there's more. If only Charlotte hadn't come round to Vic's as well.
She didn't.
For a heart-to-heart. Just when I really started getting a bit closer to Vic, showing how supportive I wanted to be.
And how supportive is that, really?
Well, state she's in. I've said she could come round here for a few days. Hope you don't mind.
No, of course not. It must be awful for her stuck in that house, surrounded by all those memories of Mark.
What a mess. Listen, do you think there's any hope for me and Vic?
Who knows? You both really need time. Then you'll know.
Oh, you finally come home then, have you? Where have you been? Jimmy, I've been worried sick. I said, where have you been?
Walking. Ended up down by the river.
Got a talk with her yet?
Oh, she locked herself in her room, didn't she, when you went off into the night?
Yeah, I'm not surprised she couldn't talk to you.
Jimmy, why did you say?
She deserved it.
Why? Because one of the neighbour's kids took drugs in a club. She can't be held responsible for every stupid teenager who blags the way in.
Any news about Gemma?
Not that I've heard, no. She's lucky to be alive by the sounds of it.
Yeah, lucky for our Lindsay and all.
Jimmy, it wasn't Lindsay's fault.
Mick, do you mind if I nip in to see Rachel and the new baby while we're down the Aussie?
No, of course not. At least one of us has got something to celebrate.
Any more news about Gemma, Mick?
It's knocked it a bit, you know. Adverse reaction, the doctor said.
Oh, poor kid.
Adverse reaction? Tell her the truth, Sin. She's lying there with tubes coming out of her. She's only a kid and she's on a catheter. She might die, all right?
I was only asking, love.
Can I leave a message with you for your Lindsay?
Yeah, go on.
What? They only had the police on me back, haven't I, because of her?
Oh, Linz, why?
Probably the same reason my daughter's in hospital.
I ended up in the cop shop, you can tell. I get in the third degree after busies.
Hey, hang on, love, hang on.
Never mind, hang on. I've been interviewed by the police and all. I've told them if my daughter dies, I'll be holding Lindsay responsible.
How come?
And I'll be doing the same if I lose my licence.
You can tell her that as well.
And just tell her I want it, okay?
What's she been doing, sir?
She wouldn't be in hospital if it wasn't for your Lindsay.
How's the packing going, love?
All right.
I thought you might need this.
Pan it all up on the bed first. I'll put it in bags later.
Not all this, though.
Why not?
No, love. We can't take everything we own with us. Just the things we need or the things we really want.
You are joking, Mum.
No, we're not going to have the room, Kelly. Come on. Let's have a sort through, eh? Look, you're a bit old for this, aren't you?
Leo gave me that. I don't want to leave it behind.
It's the same for all of us, love.
I don't want to go.
No, neither do I. But what else can we do, hey? Staying around here isn't going to help any of us.
Why did he have to do it, eh, Mum? How would he feel if some fella drugged me and raped me, his own sister?
Come here, love.
All right.
Hello. Looks like you're moving out there.
Yeah, well, not really. I'm just going to have to stay at our port for a couple of days. Thought I'd spend a bit more time around there for a change.
Things got a bit much for you here, have they?
Something like that.
I've had a talk with Niamh.
I'm washing my hands of the lot of them, just so you know.
What a sad business, eh?
I know. And I was just too carrying on like Bessie's. It's a cruel world.
I'll second that. Well, I'll leave you two packing.
See ya.
Loading up now, then?
No way. Your mother wants us to wait till after dark. She doesn't want us parading our shame through the streets in broad daylight.
We had a breach of security. It happens all the time.
And I might just say that's your cover story, then. I might tell the Finnegans it was you that sold the dodgy gear. They wouldn't be very happy with you then, will they? The dealer they thought they could trust.
Why are we here, Lindsay?
I want you to help me.
Is that all you want?
You really don't want the Finnegans thinking it was you that let them down, do you? Wouldn't do your career prospects any good at all.
So if I was to help you out, what would you want me to do?
Well, the club's going to be worth nothing for a while now, is it? You could tell them that. Just tell them that some scally kid dealer got in and spoiled the party. You could tell them that the busies are crawling all over the place. You could advise them, couldn't you? Tell them just to cut the losses.
And what about the money you owe them?
Oh, well, I've got any choice. Just have to sell me house.
I can try and talk to them, but I can't promise anything.
Dave, you're a very persuasive kind of guy. I reckon they'd listen to you.
We make a good team, you know. You without your partners, me without the Finnegans. You and me together.
Just drive me home, okay?
You sure?
I said drive.
There you go.
Thanks. Can't believe how much tea I've drunk this week.
I've tried her mobile, but it keeps diverting. I've even left a message with her mum.
Or maybe she's at the club.
She's not. I've been there and all.
Have a cup of tea?
Yeah. Go on, please. I mean, Gemma's lying in hospital, Susanna screaming blue murder. And where's Cruella Corkill? Vanished like nothing's happened and I'm left carrying the can. I've known all along, she'd never have gone to business with her. Oh, I'm sorry. I'll try not to be so wound up in my own problems.
No, you carry on, you've got every right to be upset. Lindsay's tarnishing your name by association.
Yeah, well, that's nothing to what I want to do to her.
Yeah, if it was me, I'd want to kill her.
Oh, Vic, I'm sorry. I haven't even asked how you are.
I'm fine. Why shouldn't I be?
Well, you know, because of Mark and that.
Why? He's not going to be bothering us anymore. We should be celebrating. He's well and truly out of our lives now, isn't he? Just what we all wanted. And no one more so than me.
Shouldn't we be phoning the garage? Tell Jackie we're both sick or something?
No one's phoning anywhere. I want us packed up and out of here without anyone knowing.
Come on, Vic. You mustn't talk like this. It was a tragic accident.
Yeah, so everyone's assumed.
He fell and he broke his neck.
How come everyone's so sure that he fell? None of us were there. How do we know he didn't throw himself down the stairs?
Come on, Vic. If Mark had wanted to kill himself, do you seriously think that's the way he'd have chosen?
He'd have been more likely to take an overdose or something.
And how come everyone's suddenly an expert on Mark? Except for me. I know better than anyone what sort of state of mind he was in before he died.
Even if he did throw himself down the stairs, why should you start torturing yourself? It would have been his decision, his choice, not your fault. Am I right?
Yeah, I guess, yeah.
Believe us. There's nothing you could have done either way.
Oh, Granddad.
Sir, I love.
See you around, then.
Take it easy, shall
I? Take it easy.
I'll be off now. I'll be wondering where I am.
We'll phone you, OK?
Yeah, great.
Let you know we've arrived safely. I promise you'll keep in touch, Dad. Maybe you could come over and see us sometime.
Not while he's with you. And for the rest of you, you know where I am. If you're all opposite me. You've wrecked this family. Do you know that, lad? You've wrecked it!
Dad.
Mum, you don't have to put yourself through this. Wouldn't it be easier if I just got off and left you all here to get on with your lives? This is all my fault in the first place. It shouldn't be the rest of you being punished as well.
What's happening here, Luke? It's like a torture to you, isn't it?
It's worse.
Well, maybe that's how it's meant to be. Because the law never punished you for what you did. So maybe this is God's way of making you pay.
How long hang about?
Lindsay, the idea of that young girl being on the critical list. That really does upset me, you know.
Well, don't tell me. Try telling Dad.
Hey, you get out here now!
Come
on, get out! My little girl's in intensive care because of you.
There's nothing to do with
me. With the machine that's breathing for her, now get out!
To the scally that sold her the gear!
Just as we were starting to enjoy ourselves. Do you mind if I go and raid the supplies?
I've never seen her like this before.
I'd be getting off my head if I'd gone through what she has.
What do you think?
What about her getting smashed?
About Mark. She seems pretty certain he was suicidal.
He wasn't that far gone, was he?
But we have to keep talking about him like this. Can't we just wait and see what the inquest says?
Found a friend. The empty vessel. Listen, we'll leave you to it, eh?
Oh, no. You're not in the party mood, then?
Bit tired, Red.
But I wanted to talk about your engagement and the wedding and dates and stuff. Maybe tomorrow, eh?
Yeah. Good night.
Night. We'll drink your share. And Mark's. That's what he would have wanted.
Right. That's the last of my bags. What about you? When are you going to Bosco's?
I'll go when all yous go.
What's going on?
I've been trying to write a sort of a letter of apology.
To who?
Nikki Chadwick. And her mother, I suppose. About Luke and everything, really. It's hard, though, because I didn't learn to write to have to write a letter like this.
Right, then, let's hear it.
Hear what?
Why are Lindsay suddenly public enemy number one round here?
I've told you.
You told me nothing? Do you know what kind of a day I've had, eh? I've had Mick Johnson on at me, Jackie Dixon, even Sinbad, all about our Lindsay. Now, I don't care whether you think she should tell me herself or not, Jimmy. I just want to know what she's done.
You're not going to like it, love.
Jesse, I just wanted you to know, after all we said yesterday, I'll be standing by Luke because he needs me. And because I'm his mother.
You're a brave woman.
I also just wanted to say that I hope now that Nikki knows who did it. That she'll be able to get on with the rest of her life.
She's always known.
Well, at least she's had it proved to herself then.
Yeah, I know what you mean. And I hope now she'll be able to start looking for the future as well. She'd be lucky if she can. You know, all over Christmas, every prayer I said, I couldn't stop thinking about all those other women out there who've had this desperate thing done to them and how they must feel, not knowing who it was.
Yeah, it doesn't bear thinking of, I don't know.
And they've got to go on with their lives, not knowing if the rapist was somebody they work with or they're sitting in a lecture with. Or somebody who's sitting next to them on the bus.
Luke's destroyed, you know. He really is.
I can't say I feel sorry for him.
No, I wouldn't expect you to. Jesse, I don't hardly ask you this.
I'm not sure I want to hear it.
I know you go to church. Would you pray for Luke? Thank me when you're trying to wake up for work.
Sunday tomorrow.
Excellent. Poor Mark. Couldn't face it, could he? Long, slow death.
It's not easy for anyone, whatever the illness.
All he really wanted was for me to be there for him. Till the end. I couldn't face that, could I? Because I'm too selfish. I wasn't prepared to give. I wouldn't sacrifice, would I? For the man that I was supposed to have loved more than anything in the world. The man who I stood next to at the altar. The man who held my hand and promised to cherish me.
Vic.
I'm sorry. He knew I couldn't handle it, so he took himself out.
Vic, please.
What else could he have done? He knew, the worse he got, that I wasn't going to be there for him. He would have been on his own. And because I couldn't cope, he lost the will to carry on.
Stop it. You are not to blame for this.
If I'm not, who is? It's not Mark's fault he was sick.
I knew the state of mind he was in as well, remember? And I was the last person with him. And I was stupid enough to leave him alone. So if anyone's to blame for however he died, it's me.
I'm sorry, Lord. But I don't think I can find it in me to forgive him for what he did to my precious granddaughter. Even though I need you to forgive me for the hatred I feel inside me. I need you now. I really need you.
We've been reduced to, like thieves in the night. This will be you getting off then, bye.
Take care of yourself, okay? Remember how much we love you and how much we'll be thinking about you.
I can bring Bosco from the boat, can't I? Tell him I want to stay with you. Better get in then, bye.
Sorry, Ma. I really am.
We better go. No, Luke. No, don't look back. No, it's tomorrow. We've got a face up to now.
Restored, all right. And that is the last time you use that key to get into my house.
Mom.
Understand? Go on. Get into the gutter where you belong. Dad!
Inside,
keep out of it, Jimmy! What are you doing letting your club be overrun by drug dealers, eh? And turning a blind eye? After everything you saw they did to your father, well, you saw how it nearly destroyed us and it killed your brother!
But I had no choice,
Mom. Listen, little German is a dipstar because
Jackie,
of you!
Hey,
Jimmy,
you've got
leave me alone,
blood
will
on
you?
The arch there!
You're a mother, Lindsay, and you were selling drugs to other mothers' children, weren't you?
Well, get real, Mum. People who go to clubs want to buy drugs, so someone's going to supply it regardless.
Have you heard this?
So I could either go along with it and let some little out-of-control scallies have free reign, or let Dave get involved.
How sick can you get?
Sick or not sick, Mum? This is the real world, all right?
No, it's not all right. It's all wrong. It's all wrong.
I'll tell her.
Go on, Lindsay. Get out of my sight.
Why would a 13-year-old want to pop a pill and run?
He'd still be alive if I'd loved him enough to stay with him in the first place.
Do you know what? You couldn't have given me a better present than that. And I'll always love you as much as Nan Amanda loved me.
So, Council of War, what are we going to do about Lindsay?
Whoa, Lindsay could do with a getaway on The Real Holiday Show, which is exactly where Four's taking you next, to meet the lady who's always in the pink and to look for love in Tel Aviv.